So you've just gotten into Web3 auditing, you've learned Solidity, you've read the audit reports, you've done the CTFs, and you decided that you're ready for your first real audit. So you dive in and join an ongoing C4 contest, and you go and open the GitHub and read the first contract and have absolutely no idea what's going on in the code. Instead of feeling overwhelmed and wondering how you'll get any findings, in this video, I'm going to give you a complete guide to exactly how you can break down the code base and start to digest it and really make this first audit as easy and approachable as possible so that you can get those sweet, sweet findings as early on as possible. All right, but first, why should you listen to me? My name is Owen, and over a year and a half ago, I founded Guardian Audits. And since then, we've uncovered dozens and dozens of critical and high vulnerabilities in over 100 different smart contracts. And my goal with all of the videos that I put out, and especially this one, is to distill down everything that I've learned by spending over 1,000 hours auditing smart contracts and give everything to you so that you can ultimately become a much better smart contract auditor than I ever could be. All right, without further ado, let's get right into the complete guide for your first audit. Okay, like I said, in this video, this is going to be a comprehensive guide to your first audit and a guide that you can use moving forward for subsequent audits that you do. In this guide, we're going to cover four things. First, we're going to talk about the ideal auditing mindset. And then we're going to explore how we can effectively break things down in the system and really get to understand them very quickly. And then we're going to talk about audit tags. And finally, we're going to cover how to best organize and utilize attack knobs. Okay, so let's first discuss the mindset. The most important part of the audit begins before you even open the code base. It is your mindset going into the audit. I promise you that you do indeed have the capability to find valid and high impact vulnerabilities in whichever code base you're looking at. You just have to believe this yourself. Your first code base is going to be hard for a number of reasons, but above all, I believe the reason why your first audit is the hardest is because you have to build up that confidence to really believe that you can point out high impact issues that are actually valid findings. So as you're going through this audit and you're following the subsequent steps in the guide, and any sort of thought creeps up on you along the lines of, I don't have enough experience yet, or maybe you're having a feeling that you're not smart enough to understand the code, or not smart enough to comment on the code, or any of these stupid reasons, ignore them and push forward. Trust me, you're going to be extremely glad that you did. Once you have a few audits under your belt, it literally becomes easier to open a new code base, understand the code, and point out valid vulnerabilities in it because you simply believe in your track record of being able to do that. And so this first audit is absolutely paramount to build up that confidence in your ability. Okay, so now that we've covered that aspect of the mindset, let's talk about a different belief, the belief that the developers made no mistakes. Of course, you have to believe in your ability to audit, but of course, you also have to believe that vulnerabilities exist to be found in the first place. Virtually no code base goes through a real audit with literally zero findings. To prove to yourself that there really are findings in abundance in every single contest or audit or anything like that, go and look at all of the C4 reports of past contests and just see literally how many different findings are uncovered. And also notice how many different individual wardens report unique findings. If that's not enough, go and check out the reports from Guardian on our GitHub. And you can see the last few audits alone that we've released each have 50, 60, 70, or even 100 different unique findings in each of these reports. So clearly in every code base, there are many, many different findings to be had. And as long as you believe that they exist and you believe that you have the ability to uncover them, you will find them. Okay, now let's dive in and talk a little bit about breaking the system down. So first of all, it is extremely important to really discuss how you're actually learning the system and understanding the system, because context is everything during an audit. Once you understand the system as a whole, different possible vulnerabilities and bugs start to jump out at you and literally hit you on the head as you're reading the code. Once you understand the system, you can go back and look at any particular line or any particular question you had and immediately understand if it is a valid issue and exactly how critical it could be. So our number one goal when we're jumping into this first audit, and of course subsequent audits that you do, is to gain context on the system as fast as possible. Okay, so here's exactly how we're going to do that. First of all, list out on literally a notepad, or you could even do this in the smart contracts themselves, the high level jobs to be done of the system. What are the tasks that need to be accomplished by the system? For example, for an exchange, of course, users need to swap and users need to be able to provide liquidity. Users also need to be able to withdraw liquidity. And I imagine there's some sort of fee collection mechanism going on there as well. Go ahead and list these things out for whatever particular system you're auditing. And now you're going to use this to go through and start to understand the protocol in this way. Literally go down this list and start to walk through the path in the smart contracts of how each of these tasks is actually accomplished and try to understand the high level meaning of every function along the way. You'll see in my live auditing series in the first episode, what I did is I listed out all the high level jobs to be done of the system, and then I proceeded to go through and check off on the list as I went each of these jobs in the system. I would go through each of the functions, expand each individual function, and look through it until I understood from a high level exactly what the logic was doing. So now this enables us to break down the code into really digestible atomic pieces. And now you have a roadmap of exactly the logic that you need to understand to be able to get full context on the system, to be able to understand exactly how the system functions. This way I go through the protocol the way that the developers designed it. If I was a developer creating the protocol, I wouldn't start with some niche utility function. I would start with the main functionality and then work my way through the contracts there. Okay, so now this is where audit tags come in. Exactly when we're going through these high level jobs to be done of the system and walking our path in the contracts. Now, like I mentioned, context is everything. And during an audit, we have limited time, of course. A contest doesn't last forever, and of course, you can't spend an entire year on a single smart contract. So we need to be very focused on being quite efficient with our time. And since context is everything, and you'll be 100 times more efficient at identifying vulnerabilities after you have context, we need to focus 110% on gaining context and leave any rabbit holes or initial ideas by the wayside. But we absolutely do not want to lose track of any of these initial ideas that you have. And so this is exactly where audit tags come in. As you're doing this initial review and you're starting to walk the code paths of each individual job to be done of the system, when you notice things like a potential reentrancy or you have a question about a particular edge case, leave a comment in the code with an @audit tag. And this way you know that this is something that you thought of earlier on, and you can always grep the code base and search for @audit and find these tags again and readdress them. Here you can see in our live audit series, me actually noting a edge case that I was thinking of at the time, but I didn't want to dive into, where a position could have zero liquidity. It's very important to note that I don't immediately explore this edge case, but I leave it as a note to come back to later. This way we're able to stay laser focused on the process of gaining context And this is overall going to help us work through the audit a lot more efficiently overall. Okay, so you're leaving audit tags in the code as you go, as you're reviewing these high-level jobs to be done. But we need a more organized and efficient way to systematically come up with attack vectors. And so this is where the idea of knobs comes in. Knobs are essentially just any interesting behavior you see in the code that could potentially be used to cause any kind of bug or vulnerability. Examples of great knobs are any external calls to an arbitrary address, divisions that can potentially round down to zero or cause precision loss, divisions that could revert with a divide by zero, or subtractions that could potentially underflow revert. Those are just a few generic ones that apply to all Solidity code bases. But more often than not, really, really great knobs are actually unique to the code base itself and have to do a lot with the context of the code base. For example, in our live audit series, I noted that in the Uniswap V3 staker contract, in fact, anybody can unstake for another user once the incentive key has ended. This is a fantastic knob, and it's one that actually ended up yielding us a high impact finding where a malicious actor could actually unstake for the LP staker contract and actually end up stealing rewards from other stakers. When you encounter things like this in the code, add them to a running list. This is your list of knobs. This way, after you have full context on the system, now when you go back and start to look at these functions again at a closer, granular detail, you can have this list of knobs to evaluate the effect of every one of these knobs on each function that you're looking at. And this way you get to see if you can twist any of these knobs to be able to find a potentially critical vulnerability. It's also extremely useful to build out this list because oftentimes you'll be able to combine one or more of these knobs with other knobs in order to yield a actual high impact finding. All right, so those are four things that you want to keep in mind as you're going through your first audit, and of course in subsequent audits, to be able to easily break down the system, digest it, keep track of all of your ideas, and then be able to really efficiently and ultimately easily come up with as many vulnerabilities and bugs as you possibly can. I sincerely hope that this process helps you out. And if you have any more questions on it, feel free to reach out on Twitter or Discord or anything like this. If you're looking to grow your connections in the Web3 space and get any auditing related questions that you have asked, or even participate in team audits where you can team up with others from all across the world who are also interested in auditing smart contracts and conduct a real life audit and get rewarded for it, then go and check out the Solidity Lab at lab.guardianaudits.com and go ahead and apply to join our community of aspiring and growing auditors. And of course, if you're not entirely confident in your Web3 auditing abilities just yet, and you do want to go the paid route, then I actually collaborated with several other top DeFi researchers in the field to bring you exactly what you're looking for. Johnny Time created the Smart Contracts Hacking course, where you can learn literally everything that will take you from just plain Solidity knowledge to a certified smart contract auditing pro, with dozens and dozens of hours of lecture content, as well as dozens and dozens of corresponding exercises and bonus guest lectures from myself and several other top tier auditors in the space. So if that sounds like something that would help you out and you would actually be willing to go the paid route, it's something that you're looking for, then go ahead and feel free to take $50 off at checkout when you use the link in the description below. All right, that is all for this time. I can't wait to see you in the next one.